This is Michael Takos with the Enterprise Data and Analytics team. Today I'm going to show you how to export your calendar data from Outlook and load it into Excel into a pivot table to do some analytics on where you're spending your time. For the purposes of this video, Outlook is just a convenient data source. The real value is in learning how powerful pivot tables can be. So the three main objectives are to get your data out of Outlook, to massage that data into a more usable form, and then to do analytics using a pivot table. First, what we need to do is get the data out of Outlook. So open up Outlook and go look at your calendar. One of the things that will really help us with the analytics is if you use categories. To use a category, just select an event and go to categorize, and you can choose whatever color you want to mean whatever you want. But to get more specific, we need to go to all categories, and I need to rename green category to one-on-one or whatever category you're trying to create. And so now when I export that data, that's going to show up as a one-on-one. So let's jump right into exporting the data. You go to File, you go to Open and Export, Import Export, click Export to a File, and then click Next. We want comma separated values, so click Next, and make sure that your calendar is selected, and click Next. It's going to ask you where to save it. I'm saving it to my desktop, and I'm just calling it test.csv. You can name it whatever you want and click Next. All right, this step is optional, but if you have difficulty exporting your calendar, if it takes a long time, this may help. Go into Map Custom Fields, and over on the To side, find Description and remove it. Description is a large freeform field. It just describes all of your meetings. It's not very helpful in analyzing, so kick it out and hit OK. Then click Finish and choose a date range that you're interested in looking at. So now we've exported our data, and it is on our desktop. I'm going to use somebody else's calendar because it's got more interesting data. First and foremost, I would highly recommend that you turn this data set into a table. To do that, go to Insert and tell it Table. It's going to assume that you want the data set that you're clicked in, which we do, and it's going to assume that we have headers, and it's correct. So click OK, and now you have a table. The reason this table is so beneficial is that you can filter and sort very easily, and you can apply a function to every row in the table. And we are on to step two. We're going to massage the data to make our analytics better. So we need to calculate the duration of these meetings. To do that, we need to insert a new column. And you do that by right-clicking and choosing Insert. And now we need to enter a formula. We need to combine the end date and the end time together, and then subtract the combination of start date and start time. So end date plus end time minus start date plus start time. And we've got our answer, although our answer is formatted in the wrong format. So we're going to format our cells, and we're going to use a custom time format. That custom time format is bracket HH. Bracket colon mm. What that is hours colon minutes. And now our calculation is correct. You can see 30 minutes for the 2 to 2:30 p.m. You can see 2 hours for the 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Our formula is concatenating our end date and end time, as well as our start date and start time, and then subtracting start date, start time from end date, end time, which gives us the duration of the meeting. Next, we need to rename the column. Column one's not very descriptive, so let's call it hours. So now let's analyze some data. Go to the Insert tab and click Pivot Table. Excel is going to assume that we want to look at the data in the last area we had clicked, which is table one, and it's correct. We'll put it in a new worksheet and click OK. We now have an empty pivot table. First and foremost, let's take a look at the sum of hours. Drag hours down to value. Excel guesses we want a count of hours, which is not correct. So click on the little black arrow and go to value field settings. Change count to sum, and while we're in here, go to number format and go to the custom field and change that to bracket HH bracket colon MM. That way we won't have to format, it'll just understand that we want hours and minutes. Click OK. And now we have a total of 278 hours, but that includes all day events. So why don't we filter out all day events by dragging all day events to filters, and then click on the little down arrow and choose false. That will grab all records where all day event is false. So we have 38 hours of meetings to look at in the month of April, which is what we've exported. Let's start with categories. Grab categories and drag it to the rows, and that should break out our time into one-on-ones, management, orange category, workday, and blank. Blank is where our meeting has no category. So let's say you don't have a lot of categories set. What else can you look at? Well, location is interesting. So let's remove categories and drag location down to rows. This shows that we have a lot of meetings, or a lot of time spent in meetings, in the cafeteria, in OIM 147, and a few other random spots. 13 and a half hours of meetings at an unknown location. Another thing we can look at is who is scheduling our meetings, who's inviting us. So let's remove location and let's grab meeting organizer and drag it to the rows. So you can see who is scheduling most of your meetings. And in this case, both Troy and John are scheduling a lot of hours. Lastly, why don't we take a look at how many meetings we're going to. Grab the field subject and drag it to values. Excel doesn't know how to sum or average subject, so it assumes you want a count, and it's correct that we do indeed want a count. You can see that we have 33 meetings scheduled by Troy and 13 meetings scheduled by John. This is just the beginning of the kind of analytics you can do with Excel pivot tables. I hope this has been helpful, and I hope you'll continue to explore what you can do with pivot tables. For more information and more tutorials like this, please go to the EDA website and check out our other videos. Thank you for watching.